Telco giant PLDT slapped with multiple class suits in the U.S. over its 48 billion peso budget overrun disclosed in December. The details in this report.
At least three American law firms have filed class suits against PLDT and its top executives, including Chairman Manuel Pangilinan, seeking to recover losses which they claim are a direct result of misleading statements made to investors pertaining to the telco's spending plans and financial health for the period 2019 through 2022. These are the years covering the 48 billion pesos or close to 900 million U.S. dollars in capital expenditure overruns disclosed to the public last December. One of the complaints was made public online by the Rosen Law Firm. It alleges all of the disclosures and commentary of PLDT and its executives from 2019 through 2022 were false and misleading and or lacked reasonable basis at all relevant times because they did not disclose the budget overruns nor the internal weaknesses which allowed the overruns to occur. The complaint names PLDT and its executives Chairman Manuel Pangilinan, President Alfred Panlilio, Chief Financial Officer Annabel Chua, and several others as defendants. News of the class action suits were first reported by the Inquirer. In a disclosure to the Philippine Stock Exchange clarifying Inquirer's report, PLDT said it has not been served with the documents mentioned in the Inquirer report, and its company policy is not to comment on impending or pending litigation. Pangilinan is currently in Japan as part of President Marcos Jr.'s private business delegation. PLDT is listed on the Philippine Stock Exchange with ticker symbol TEL, and its American depository shares are listed on the New York Stock Exchange with ticker symbol FI. One analyst expects the matter to continue to impact PLDT's share price at the Philippine Stock Exchange.
On the issue with what we always say to our clients regarding this is that sans any drastic changes to management or more material updates with regards to the overruns, the issue will continue to impose a ceiling on TEL's share price. And valuation-wise, this will continue to warrant a corporate governance discount on the stock. So the market is likely to wait for further comments regarding it and the next analyst briefing for PLDT.
PLDT shares fell close to 20% after the capex overruns were disclosed in December, wiping away over $1 billion in market value. It has since managed to recoup some of those losses. It closed at 1,380 pesos per share on Friday, February 10. Its 52-week low is 1,130 pesos. Its 52-week high is at 1,984. The Securities and Exchange Commission earlier launched a probe of its own into its PLDT's capex overruns. It has yet to respond to requests for an update. PAC President Ramon Monzon meanwhile told ANC as early as December that they had found no evidence of fraud in their own investigation.
We're looking at the PLDT trades for the last month and a half. I am not at liberty to let you to tell you yet the results. Without going to specifics, we didn't see any indication of any fraudulent trades prior to the disclosure. We looked at buying and selling, and a lot of the transactions are really institutional trades, not personal trades, and mostly by foreign brokers.
PLDT has categorically stated that capex overruns were not a result of any fraudulent activity.
In other news, Public Attorney's Office Chief Percy de Acosta denies coercing a witness to testify against detained former Senator Laila de Lima. De Lima's lawyer made that claim Friday after a hearing into the allegation that former Bureau of Corrections OIC Rafael Ragos delivered 10 million pesos in drug money to the former senator on November and December 2012. But the Public Attorney's Office called it false and misleading, saying Ragos never made such a statement in any of the hearings. The PAO also slammed Ragos for saying that two other public attorneys pressured him to execute an affidavit. The office accused Ragos of making that claim to make his recantation appear convincing.